All right, good morning, world. Yes, I am backing out of my driveway and filming myself, and yes, technically it's illegal in the state that I live in, but live fast, die young, am I right? So, it's Tuesday, and I am on my way to school, and I am late, so what a great way to top the day off. I woke up at the time I was supposed to leave to be at chapel, and so I just did not go to chapel. And it's mandatory, and I've already missed two, and they say if you miss three, you get some kind of punishment, and I already know I'm gonna miss another one before the semester's over, so I can't wait to see what's gonna happen to me. But anyway, I'm on my way to my first class now, and still running late for that because of just who I am as a human being. But anyway, it's Tuesday, my dudes. Alright, so that class was my actual nightmare. No, I usually love that class, but today we were talking about, like, how do you define self? And she had all of us write down on a piece of paper, like, how we would define ourselves. And I have no freaking idea who I am. But I was still, you know, writing my little bullet points. Then she's like, alright, so before you read off your perceptions of yourself, we're gonna go around the room and everyone's gonna say something that they perceive of you. That's my actual nightmare, hearing what people think of me. And, like, I guess being in a classroom setting, like, no one's really gonna say anything negative, so it was still, like, a safe place to do it. But that's so scary to me, hearing what people think of me. And, I mean, again, it was nothing negative. Some of it I might perceive as negative, but, you know, people said that I was very opinionated. So I'm like, great, they're trying to say that I'm stubborn and loud, but that I'm, like, passionate about what I believe in, that I'm very, like, honest and open, which I am, but I feel like it's almost to a fault, because I'm like, if I would just shut up and stop telling everyone literally every detail of my life in the most honest, brutal way, it would be great, but anyway, so I drove to the library because the weather is foggy, rainy mess, and I look like a little monster. My bad skin. I feel weird. Glad I spent like an hour last night straightening my hair, only for it to rain. I'm driving like 100 feet to my next class, so I don't have to walk in this. I'm trying to make today a good day. I'm trying, but today is trying me. It's pressing me and stretching me. But I have one more class, and I'm hoping she doesn't let us out too late because I'm writing, a letter to that guy from Owl City, you know? And I know that's cheesy, but whatever, and I'm hoping to find a way to get it to him tonight, whether I get to meet him in person, which seems impossible, or pass it along through someone, but it's a long one, it's a doozy. Got about 10 years of love to cram into that baby, so I would need to have time to finish that and put it in an envelope, and have time to, like, do my makeup and get dressed. So of course, class ran long, the one day I needed it to not run long, but I'm getting gas, and I hate getting gas at BP because at literally every single gas station, the green one is the diesel one, and here the green one is the not diesel one, so I spend like a good like minute and a half staring, like making sure I'm not about to pump my car full of diesel. So shout out to BP for making the weirdest marketing decision ever. I'm behind a school bus and I want to die. I'm doing a very rushed version of the makeup I wanted to wear. So I'm not going all out like I wanted to. So this is powder foundation.
from Bare Minerals, just to try to cover up the sin on my face. I think my phone's slowly sinking. I'm using a purple color from this palette called Everlasting. I don't know if that's, they're called Real Colors or they're called Everlasting. I don't know who they are. And there goes my phone. I don't know who they are, but this was like $7 at Sally's.
Oh my God, fine, never mind then.
All right, so this is the final look. I wish I got full mirror view, but I forgot. Maybe I will get one when I get there, I don't know. But I am super late. I am leaving my house at the time I wanted to be there. And I live an hour away, so, oh my God, please go slower. Please go slower. That's what I want. I'm stressed out as heck. I packed these anti-inflammatories that I was given in the hospital after like an accident, so they're super strong, but I have a feeling I'm gonna need them because I am wearing combat boots and I already know I'm gonna suffer, but I need to be taller than people there because I'm super short. And also they make me feel like I can kick someone's butt, and that's the kind of confidence I need when I'm about to be alone in a city. So I'm gonna try to sneak my pepper spray in the venue because it does me no good in the car. Here's hoping I'm able to do it. I've done it twice. Also, while I'm on a road that's safe to, you know, not pay attention on, I just want to say, yes, I'm wearing an Owl City shirt, and yes, I'm seeing Owl City play in concert. It's so dumb to me that people think that it's not cool to wear the shirt of the band you're going to see to the concert. Like, people who think that are so full of themselves, it's ridiculous. Why not? I mean, give me a good reason why not, other than you don't look cool. Like, no one looks cool at a concert when you're screaming and jumping up and down. If you're there to look cool, then don't go, because you're ruining you're ruining it for the rest of us. So anyway, don't let anyone tell you what to do or what not to do, because it's not cool. It's just stupid. I just parked and the line is super long. So I'm home. The show was really good.
I didn't vlog, like, after and stuff when we were waiting around to try to meet the band, just because in the city to have, like, my phone out and be filming myself and not paying attention to my surroundings, and then, like, walking into my car afterwards, like, I was with a group of girls, so, like, I felt safe, but just still wise to not be distracted. So I took, like, that short clip of me driving home, which I shouldn't have done, but, like, I was excited, but, like, I just kind of was just excited for the music, and then it was, like, I don't know what happened, but just Adam Young walks out on stage, and just, like, seeing his face for, like, the first time in years, and, like, that's the face that younger me just, like, looked up to so much. I was just obsessed with him. Some of it healthy, some of it not, I'm sure, but seeing that face again, it just, like, brought back so much excitement and just, like, childish giddiness, seeing him and hearing the music and watching him play the music and seeing him seem to genuinely enjoy playing the music. There, it was just Matt Thiessen and the Earthquakes that opened with just, like, a few acoustic songs, honestly, and then Owl City came on, and it just all went by really fast, but, like, it was a short set. I've already said this, like, 1,000 times, but everyone there was so young. I don't understand how everyone there was so young. Like, I just assumed that everybody became fans, like, when Ocean Eyes came out in, like, 2009, and that we all just kind of grew up and are still fans and, like, haven't really accumulated new fans. But, I mean, some people said that there were a lot of adults, like, my age there, but where I was standing, I was the oldest person. Like, I'm not even kidding. I was asking people's ages. The next oldest person around me was probably 17 or 18 at most. And then, like, right in front of me was, like, an 8-year-old. I'm like, am I at a children's show? Like, I know his music's, like, clean and kind of silly and stuff. So, I mean, like, I guess I get it. But at the same time, I just was blown away at the number of, like, actual literal children and parents at the show. So yeah, hung out after the show, hung out with a group of girls, got to meet Matt Thiessen, so I'll put that picture in this little area, and I was super awkward, and I think he was super annoyed that we were there waiting. You could tell, maybe not in the picture, but, like, just from talking to him, he was like, go home, why are y'all still here? Because we were waiting to see Adam, and everyone kept telling us that Adam had gone to bed, and we just thought they were lying. They kept saying Adam was asleep, and I was like, there's no way he's asleep. Like, to go from the adrenaline of being on stage, their bus was parked, like, down the road. He would have had to have run from the stage out and to the bus. Does that mean, like, he didn't even shower? Like, that just didn't make sense, that he would just go straight from performing, bolt to the bus, and then, like, immediately fall asleep and has been asleep since. Like, that, especially since he used to talk about having insomnia, but what do I know? I don't know Adam. So anyway, there was no way around it. He was in the tour bus after all, because we never saw him come out. So he was in there. He must have run, but I don't believe that he was asleep. I think that was a lie. I think he just didn't want to come out to meet us. And while that's disappointing, like, I know that he doesn't owe us anything. He doesn't owe me coming out and meeting me, even though I've, like, only been a fan for, like, 10 years and bought half your merch, but whatever. I still got to meet Matt Thiessen, and he's up there with favorite bands. This guy came up to us and was like, profiling, I know, but you could just tell by looking at him, the way he was dressed, and my cat is, hello, sir. You could just tell that he is a man that's having some struggles. Anyway, like, of all the things I've been asked by either homeless people or just, like, people up to no good, this was by far one of the most, like, dead giveaways. Like, does anyone actually fall for this? He came up to this group of young girls and said, would any of y'all mind helping me put something in the trunk of my car? Like, yeah, you mean my corpse in the trunk of your car? That's, like, the most blatant, obvious kidnapping / robbing, raping, killing scheme I've ever heard. Put yourself in my trunk so I can sell you into sex trafficking? Like, that's just... Anyway, while he was sitting there, he was like, come on, please. And, like, I'm making direct eye contact with him as I pull the pepper spray out of my fanny pack. And I'm just holding it in my hand, and he just kind of looks and just kind of walks away. I guess, yeah, so that was the first concert I ever went by myself. And it was cool. It was honestly, like, it was scary just because the city scares me. Being in the city scares me. You know, just, like, a level of safety. But I always feel safe in the venue and, like, before. It's just the after the show getting to your car thing that you have to worry about, at least in my opinion. It was honestly, like, relaxing to be at a show by myself because I didn't have, like, someone else to deal with. And I know that sounds kind of snobby, but no one I know likes Owl City. So anyone who would have gone with me just either out of, like, obligation or just to hang out, but not because they genuinely enjoyed the music. So, like, I would have felt bad or, like, would have had to apologize or not get to stay late because they didn't want to, because it's not fair to make them sit outside in the concrete for 2 hours trying to meet a band member. And, like, I just got to be there and be myself and, like, not be attached to anybody. And, like, I don't know, it's hard to explain, I guess, but I guess, like, the main thing I'll say is that being alone at the show did not decrease my enjoyment by any means. Like, I enjoyed it about the same I would if I'd had somebody with me, if not a little more, just because it was just me and just focusing on myself and my own enjoyment of it. I can't take myself seriously with this cat. So if it's safe for you to do so, I definitely recommend going to, like, a concert alone, doing something like that alone. He's the worst. He curls up on me and then gets mad when I try to pet him. Like, then why are you on my lap, you turd? Then get off my lap. And he's purring. Can you hear him? A little rat. Purring while he's there. Yeah, go on. While he's abusing me. I wrote a letter to Adam. That was, like, 2 pages long. I was able to get it to him because I gave it to his guitar player and he took it inside the tour bus. So I hope he didn't just, like, throw it away. I wouldn't think so. I don't know. I have, like, a weird vibe after tonight of people, like, seeming annoyed that fans were hanging out and stuff. And, like, that's a normal thing. Every single concert I go to that's not for, like, a huge name band, that's, like, one of these smaller shows, people always hang out afterwards and usually get to meet the band. So it was just, they were acting like we were in the way when we weren't. Like, we weren't blocking anything. All they had to do was just pack up their bus and go. I don't know. I just hope he's not, like, annoyed by it, because, yeah, it's long and I feel weird about it being long, but it was, like, I just had so much I wanted to say. And that might be my only opportunity to ever say it. Because, I mean, I don't know if he'll tour again. And if he does, if I don't get to go. And then, I mean, who knows? So it was kind of like my one chance to get out all of the thoughts that I've had for almost 10 years. I mean, so I'll never know if he really read it or how he felt about it. But I just hope that, I hope he does read it. And I hope that he sees it as something, like, sweet and not something, like, annoying, like, oh my gosh, this person wrote me a freaking 2-page long letter. Like, who are they? I wouldn't have thought like that until after tonight. Now I just have this weird vibe that he, like, doesn't want anything to do with us. I'm not saying that band members owe you anything. I'm not saying that he owed us to come out and talk to us or whatever. I'm not saying that. I'm not trying to act like I'm entitled to anything. I'm not, by any means. But I also don't like the feeling that I'm a burden. I don't like that. Like, I understand if, like, they have a show in Florida tomorrow, so they've got a long way to drive and they gotta do, you know, go straight through the night. So, like, I get it, you're busy. But, like, in general, even if they didn't, like, I don't like the idea that having fans is a burden, that, like, people wanting to meet you and say nice things to you is a burden. I just hope that it's not seen as, like, a burden or an annoyance that he has this long as heck letter. I'm in a purple envelope. Hey, Do your bowls have food? Do I need to feed you? I don't want to have to go downstairs. Just tell me now. An angel. The angel is here. The good one.
What? You have an attitude?
All right.
I love you.
My foot in my mouth.